This is history 4th lesson, People's Revolt. First, Pandyas ruled our country. Pandyas were defeated by Mughals. After Mughals, Vijayanagar rulers came. The Vijayanagar rulers appointed Nayaks in their provinces. The Nayak of Madurai in turn appointed Palayakarar. Vishwanatha became the Nayak of Madurai in the year of 1529. So Vishwanatha Nayak noticed that he couldn't maintain the chieftain. He couldn't control the chiefs. So with the consultation of his ministers, Aniyananda Mudaliar and other ministers, Vishwanatha instituted Palayakara system in 1529. So this is nothing but one type of system. The whole country was divided into 72 palayams. Palayams mean villages. And each one was put under a palayakarar. So each village was headed over by the palayakarar. Palayakarar was the holder of a territory of a palayam. The palayakarars collected taxes. In each region, one palayakarar was there. All palayakarars started collecting the taxes, of which 1/3 was given to the Nayak. So, 1/3 percentage was given to the Nayak of Madurai, another 1/3 for the expenditure of the army. So, next 1/3 for the expenditure, expenses for the army, and rest, another one, was kept for themselves. Duties of the palayakarar: collect tax, govern the palayam, that is nothing but headed over the palayams. Palayam means villages. Solve the disputes. Disputes means fight. Maintain law and order. Provide military service to Nayak when needed. Early revolts of South India. During the 17th and 18th centuries, the palayakarars played a vital role in the politics of Tamil Nadu. Vital means very important role. They regarded themselves as independent. They regarded themselves as free. Among the palayakarars, there were two blocks. Blocks means divisions, namely Eastern Palayams and Western Palayams. The Eastern Palayams were the Nayaks ruled under the control of Kattabomman. So Eastern Palayams were ruled under Kattabomman, and Western Palayams ruled under Maravas. But these two palayakarars refused to pay the taxes. Revenue collecting authority to the company rule. Nawab of Arcot borrowed money from the British, but he unable to repay, re-give the debt. Debt means loan, money. Okay. Handed over the power of collecting tax to British from the palayakarar. So this duty was handed over to the British. Which duty? Collecting the taxes. Palayakarars refused it, but the palayakarars didn't accept it. Thus the conflict means fight, started between them. Pulithevar. Pulithevar was the pioneer in Tamil Nadu. Pioneer means founder, to protect against the English rule in India. He was the palayakarar of the Nerkattum Seval near Tirunelveli. Nerkattum Seval was one place name. It is near Tirunelveli. He refused to pay the tribute means tax, neither to Muhammad Ali, the Nawab of Arcot, nor to English. He refused to pay the tax to both Muhammad Ali and English. Further, he started opposing them. Hence, the forces of Nawab of Arcot and the English attacked Pulithevar. So, these two forces, Nawab forces and English forces, attacked Pulithevar. But the combined forces were defeated by Pulithevar at Tirunelveli. But Pulithevar defeated Nawab forces as well as British forces. Pulithevar was the first Indian king to have fought and defeated the British in India. So, he was the first king who defeated the English. After this victory, Pulithevan attempted to form a league of the palayakarars. League means he combined many palayakarars to oppose the British and the Nawab. In 1759, Nerkattum Seval was attacked by the forces of Nawab of Arcot under the leadership of Yusuf Khan. In 1759, this place, Nerkattum Seval, was attacked by Yusuf Khan. Pulithevar was defeated at Andanallur and the Nawab forces captured Nerkattum Seval in 1761. So, in the year of 1761, this place was captured. Which place? Nerkattum Seval. Later, Pulithevar was defeated by Captain Campbell in the year of 1767. Veerapandiya Kattabomman. The ancestors of Kattabomman belong to Andhra. They migrated to Tamil country during the 11th century. Jaga Veerapandiya Kattabomman ruled Veerapandiyapuram. Panchalankurichi was its capital. So Kattabomman's capital was Panchalankurichi. He later became a Paligar during the rule of the Nayaks. He was succeeded by his son Veerapandiya Kattabomman. So this Jagaveera Pandya succeeded by his own son Veerapandiya Kattabomman. Veerapandiya Kattabomman's wife was Jakkammal and his brothers were Oomaithurai and Sevathaiya. Nawab of Arcot. After the decline of Vijayanagar Empire, the Mughals established their supremacy in the south. So after the decline means defeat of Vijayanagar Empire, Mughals started establishing their supremacy. Supremacy means power in the south. The Nawabs acted as their representatives in Karnataka. So who were the representatives for the British? Yes, the Nawabs. Panchalankurichi Palayam was acted as an ally to the Nawab of Arcot. Ally means nothing but to unite. Hence it paid the tribute to the Nawabs. But in 1792, the political condition had completely changed. So after the year of 1792, there was a complete change in political condition. Based on the Carnatic Treaty of 1792, so 1792 one treaty was signed. The treaty name was Carnatic Treaty. Based on the Carnatic Treaty of 1792, the company gained the right to collect taxes from Panchalankurichi. The company means English started collecting the taxes from Panchalankurichi region. The collection of tribute means tax, was the main cause for the rivalry between the English and the Kattabomman. Rivalry means fight. So, English started collecting the taxes in Panchalankurichi region. So, this was the main reason for the fight between English and Kattabomman. Kattabomman met Jackson. In 1798, Colin Jackson, the collector of Ramanathapuram, wrote letters to Kattabomman asking him to pay the tribute arrears. Tribute means tax. So he asked about the tax to Kattabomman. But Kattabomman replied that he was not in a position to remit a tribute due to the famine in the country. At that time, famine happened in our country. So Kattabomman refused to pay the tax. Colin Jackson got angry and decided to send an expedition to punish Kattabomman. However, the Madras government did not give permission. The collector insulted them and tried to arrest Kattabomman and his minister. Kattabomman tried to escape with his minister, but Kattabomman escaped. After that, Oomaithurai suddenly entered the fort with his men and helped the escape of Kattabomman. So after that, Oomaithurai entered. So Kattabomman escaped easily, but unfortunately, they arrested Siva Subramanian. Edward Clive and Kattabomman. After his return to Panchalankurichi, Kattabomman wrote a letter to the Madras Council narrating the misbehavior of the collector Colin Jackson. So he wrote one letter to Colin Jackson. Edward Clive, the governor of Madras. So Edward Clive was the governor of Madras at that time. So he ordered Kattabomman to surrender. The Madras Council directed Kattabomman to appear before a committee. So he ordered the Kattabomman to appear before a committee. Meanwhile, Edward Clive dismissed the collector for his misbehavior and released Siva Subramania. Kattabomman appeared before the committee and found Kattabomman was not guilty. S.R. Lushington was appointed collector in the place of Colin Jackson. After that, Lushington was appointed instead of Colin Jackson. The Confederacy of the Palayakarars. Confederacy is nothing but coalition coalition is nothing but joined. So all the Palaikarars joined. How? During that time, Marudu Pandian of Sivaganga formed the South Indian Confederacy of rebels against the British along with the neighboring Palaikarars. So after that, Kattamumman unite all the Palaikarars. This confederacy declared proclamation which came to be known as Trichinopoly Proclamation. So this is called Trichinopoly Proclamation. Kattamumman was interested in this confederacy. He tried to establish his influence over Sivagiri, who refused to join with alliance of the rebels. But Sivagiri Palaikarar didn't join to Kattamumman. Kattamumman advanced towards Sivagiri, but the Palaikar of Sivagiri was a tributary to the company. But this Palaikarar, Sivagiri Palaikarar, paid a regular tax to the English East India Company. So the company considered the expedition of the Kattamumman as a challenge to their authority. So the company ordered the army to march to Panjalankurchi. So the company's army marched to Panjalankurchi. Fall of Panjalankurchi. Major Venaman commanded the troop. On 1st September, ultimatum was sent to Kattamumman to surrender. Ultimatum is nothing but a final statement of terms and conditions. But Kattamumman refused. On September 5, entire force reached Panjalankurchi. Kattamumman escaped to Pudukottai. Afterwards, Kattamumman escaped to Pudukottai. British put a price for his head. British fixed one price for Kattamumman's head. Finally, Kattamumman was hanged from a tamarind tree in the old fort of Kayathar. Thus ended the life of a celebrated Palaikarar of Panjalankurchi. Kattamumman's life ended. Kattamumman's heroic deeds, many folk ballads which kept his memory alive. But Kattamumman's memory still be with us. Velunachiyar. Velunachiyar was a queen of Sivagangai. At the age of 16, she was married to Muthu Vadaganathar, the Raja of Sivagangai. Muthu Vadaganathar was a Raja of Sivagangai. Velunachiyar was married to Muthu Vadaganathar. In 1772, the Nawab of Arcot and the British troops invaded Sivagangai. They killed Muthu Vadaganathar in Kalayar Koil battle. Battle means fight. Velunachiyar escaped with her daughter Velachi Nachiyar and lived under the protection of Gopala Nayakar at Virupachi near Dindukal. Afterwards, Velunachiyar escaped with her daughter. Her daughter name was Velachi Nachiyar. During this period, she organized an army and employed her intelligent agents to find where the British stored. She recaptured Sivagangai and was again crowned as queen with the help of Marudu brothers. She recaptured her own place. She was the first queen to fight against the British colonial power in India. She was the first woman to oppose the British. She is known by Tamils as Veeramangai and also known as Jhansi Rani of South India. Marudu brothers. Marudu brothers were the sons of Mukaya Palaniappan and Ponnathal. The elder brother was called Periya Marudu. Younger brother was called Chinna Marudu. Chinna Marudu was more popular and was called Marudu Pandian. So we call Chinna Marudu as Marudu Pandian. Chinna Marudu served under Muthu Vadaganathar Periya Udaya Devar of Sivaganga. He worked under Muthu Vadaganathar. In 1772, the Nawab of Arcot laid siege of Sivaganga and captured it. In 1772, the Nawab captured the place of Sivaganga. Muthu Vadaganathar died in the battle. Muthu Vadaganathar died. However, after a few months, Sivaganga was recaptured by Marudu brothers and Periya Marudu was enthroned as the ruler. After a few months, Sivaganga was recaptured by Marudu brothers. So, Periya Marudu started ruling the country. Chinnamardu acted as his advisor. Advisor is nothing but assistant. Due to the terrorist activities against British, he was called as Line of Sivaganga. Chinnamardu was called as Line of Sivaganga. Causes for the conflict. Kattabomman was hanged to death and his brother Umaiturai and others fled to Sivaganga. Fled means escaped, where Marudupandiya gave protection to Umaiturai and other great fighters. The merchants of Sivaganga did not like the interference of the company in their internal politics. But the workers of Sivaganga didn't like that the interference of the company in the Sivagangai politics. The company waged war against Sivaganga for these two causes. So war started between Sivaganga rulers and English. The South Indian Rebellion. In February 1801, the brothers of Kattabomman, Umaiturai and Savathaiya escaped from Palayamkottai prison and reached Kamudi. Chinnamardu took them to Siruvayal, his capital. So their capital was Siruvayal. They reconstructed their ancestral fort at Panchalankurichi. Reconstructed means rebuilt the fort of Panchalankurichi. The British troops under Colin Macaulay retook the fort. But the British troops recaptured that fort. The Trichinopoly Proclamation. The Marudu Pandyas issued a proclamation of independence called Trichinopoly Proclamation in the year of June 1801. The proclamation of 1801 was the first call to the Indians to unite against the British. So this was the first proclamation to unite the Indians against British. A copy of the proclamation was pasted on the walls of the Nawab's palace in the fort of Trichy, and another copy was placed on the walls of the Sri. Marudu brothers spread the spirit of the opposition against the English everywhere. As a result, many Palayakarars of Tamil Nadu went on a rally to fight against the English. So, many Palayakarars joined together. Chinnamardu collected nearly 20,000 men to challenge the English army. Divide and rule policy followed by the English. English annexed Sivagangai. In May 1801, English attacked the rebels in Tanjavur and Trichy areas. The rebels went to Piranmalai and Kalayan Koil. They were again defeated by the forces of the English. So again these forces defeated by the English. In the end, the superior military strength and the able commanders of the British army won the battle. Afterwards, British won the battle. The rebellion failed and the English annexed Sivagangai. Again the English annexed Sivagangai in the year of 1801. The Marudu brothers were executed in the fort of Tirupathur in Ramanathapuram district. Executed means murdered. And Umaiturai and Savathaiya was captured and beheaded at Panchalankurichi. Carnatic Treaty. The Carnatic Treaty was made on 31st July 1801. British took direct control over Tamilagam and the Palayakar system came to an end. This is called Carnatic Treaty. All the forts and army were demolished. Dheeran Chinnamalai. Dheeran Chinnamalai was born at Melapalayam in Chennimalai near Erode. His original name was Tirthagiri. Dheeran Chinnamalai was trained by French military in modern warfare. He was trained by French modern warfare. He was along the side of Tipu Sultan to fight against the British. So he opposed the British and he joined with Tipu Sultan. Chinnamalai engaged in guerrilla warfare. During the final battle, Chinnamalai was betrayed by his cook Nallappan and was hanged in Sangagiri Fort in 1805. So he was killed in the year of 1805.